Hey guys, what's up? It's Josh. So for today's video, as you guys can see by the title, I wanted to talk to you guys about something that I don't know if I've talked about on my channel before, but I wanted to talk about some different things that guys will do if they're not ready to be in love. So many of the things that I talk to you guys about have to do with different signs if a guy likes you, or how to tell if like a guy is in love with you. But I think that sometimes what happens is like some people are not ready to be in relationship. And then what happens is like if you're the one that's kind of pursuing the relationship, but they're not ready, then it gets into like a weird kind of thing because you don't really know what's going on because you thought that everything that you were doing was right and they're not really responding in the way that you thought they were gonna respond. So it just becomes something that's totally weird, and like I bet a lot of people are in that situation. So I just thought that in today's video I would talk to you about a couple different signs that I think mean a guy isn't really ready to like be in a relationship with you and just really has to take some more time before he gets into another relationship. So if you guys are new to my channel, hit the subscribe button. I know there's a lot of you guys that watch my videos that aren't subscribed, so hit the button. If you guys are new to my channel, I have two other channels that I'm also running. So if you guys go and subscribe to the tech channel, which is a new channel, so if a lot of you guys didn't know, there's like a video or two videos being posted on that channel every week. And then also there's a vlog channel, so if you guys want to see more into my life, that is where you guys can go and see that. But yeah, I have three different channels, so it would mean the world to me if you guys subscribe to all three of them. So if you guys enjoyed today's video, just give it a thumbs up. And with that being said, here are a couple different things that you should look for in order to tell you that a guy isn't really ready for love. All right, so point number one is inconsistency. I think that a lot of the time when you're hanging out with somebody, one thing that like makes a really good friend is when you're hanging out with them and you see them all the time and you know that like if you called them up and you were to ask them something or if you really needed something, a good friend is gonna be there to help you through whatever it is. One thing that I think happens with guys that are kind of not ready to be in a relationship, or they were just in a relationship and they just broke up and now they're kind of like out there wandering around not really sure what to do, one thing you'll realize with those people is that they're very inconsistent. So what I mean by inconsistent is one day they're gonna be a really good friend and then the next day they're not even gonna really exist. So I think that if you are in that situation where you really like somebody but it's not really working out, one thing that you kind of need to take into consideration is that person ready to be in a relationship and ready for love if they can't be that consistent friend or person that you're kind of looking for? So that's the first thing that I think you need to kind of look for, and one thing that does play a huge part in a relationship if you are wanting to go out with somebody. So yeah, that is the first one. All right, the next thing that I think is important to look for and something that people are gonna do if they aren't ready to be in a relationship is they're gonna isolate themselves during stressful times. I think that what happens when you are ready to date somebody is like if you get into a relationship with somebody, if you're dating somebody, if you're just hanging out with somebody, I think that what people do is they kind of get in those modes where like if they have something going on in their life or if something's happening, they kind of reach out to other people to help them. But if they're not ready for a relationship, they'll be there when the times are good, but as soon as the times become bad and they like stressful things are going on, you'll start to notice that they'll like disappear and try to go and figure it out by themselves, or they'll go and hang out with other people, and you'll just notice that like on the times when they are going through a hard time or they're stressed out, they're gonna disappear. And it becomes a really weird thing because you think that if they are really into you and if you're really into them, that if they are going through a hard time that you'd be the person and they'd want you to be the person to kind of help them through it. So that's another really good sign in order to tell that somebody isn't really ready to be in a relationship, is that they can't fully open themselves up to you and they're not really ready to like trust you fully when it comes to their feelings. And it has nothing to do with you. I think that is just that they're not ready to be in that position. All right, so moving on to the next one, which I think this one out of all of them is probably the biggest reason why somebody wouldn't be ready for a relationship, and that is that they're not over a relationship that they were in the past. One thing that I think happens is when people are in a long-term relationship with somebody and then they break up, I think that that person needs a huge amount of time in order to get over whatever relationship it was that they had with that other person. I don't think that like if you're going out with somebody for 5 years or 6 years or 7 years and then all of a sudden you break up, that you're completely ready to just be dating and like going on different relationships and doing all that. I think that it definitely takes time to get over it, because if you think about it, you've shared your life and shared the things that you love doing with that other person for so long, and then now to not be doing that, you get into other relationships super fast because you kind of want to have that same thing that you had. And so I just think that when it comes down to somebody not being ready to be in a relationship, one thing that you can really and you really have to look for is if they're ready to actually be in a relationship, because they might still be hung up on the person that they were with in the past. I think that if there is a guy out there that is doing all of the things that I've already listed in this video, and you find out that like he was in a relationship for 5 years or 6 years, there's a really good chance that he's probably not ready to be in the next relationship. Just look out for that. I think that there are a couple red flags when it comes to that. I think that it just takes time to get over that. All right, so moving on to the fourth one, which I think is another sign to tell that somebody's not ready for a relationship, is when they're really vague about what they actually want. A really good way in order to tell if somebody is being vague with you or not is to basically ask them the question after you've been hanging out with them for a long time. Do you want to go out or do you want to be friends? And I think that if you guys are kind of in that relationship status where you're kind of, you're hanging out with that person, maybe you're kind of hooking up with that person, and then you're also like really good friends with that person, but like you want it to go further, but that other person keeps giving you vague answers of like, I don't really know what I want, or I want to be friends, but I don't know if I want to be in a relationship. Those are all different like things that happen. And I think that there's a really good sign that if a guy is being vague about stuff, that he's probably not ready to be in a relationship. If he doesn't really know what he wants, I just think that it all comes down to like, if he's being really vague, that means that he needs more time in order to figure out what he wants. And down the road, if it is something that works out and you guys end up going out, then that's great. Both of you guys, when you're getting into a relationship, you need to like be on the same page and to feel like you're doing the right thing. If a guy is not giving you those answers and you keep asking him like, what do you want? And he can't give you an answer, then that's definitely a red flag when it comes down to somebody not being ready to be in a relationship. All right, and the last thing that I think a guy will do if he's not ready for a relationship is he will keep his life very secretive. Like he will keep it very mysterious to you. And I think sometimes what happens is like at first, you're kind of like attracted to that. Like when you get to know somebody, one thing that you might be really into is that you don't know anything about them. But I think that over time you start to find out things about them, and then you start to realize like the things that you like and the things that you don't like. But if you start seeing somebody and then like 6 months goes by and you still know nothing about that person, that is a huge red flag. Like I think that over time, if a guy is not ready to be in a relationship, he's gonna keep his entire life secretive because he doesn't want you to know his friends, he doesn't want you to know what his life is about, like what he likes, what he doesn't like. There's just certain things that I think people keep a mystery because they don't want to like get too in-depth in a relationship with somebody. So if you're going out with somebody or if you're seeing somebody and you notice that they're keeping everything very mysterious, it might be cool at first, but you need to kind of take a step back and like find out how long he's actually been not telling you anything. And like I said, at first that's totally fine. Getting to know somebody is fun, but if you don't really know what that person likes or what they don't like or what they enjoy doing and they just keep everything a mystery, then I think that that is something that you kind of need to look further into and to try to find out like why they're actually doing that. So yeah, that's another thing that I think guys will do if they're not ready for a relationship, and just another point that like sometimes you don't really think about, but if you really do look at it, then you'll start to notice that there's something there. So those are the different points. I think there was 5 of them that I came up with for today's video. If you guys did enjoy it, then give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already. You guys can also go and subscribe to my other 2 channels, which like I said, would honestly mean the world to me because I'm trying really hard to upload more content on them. So go and check those out. If you guys have any questions or if you guys wanna reach out to me and you have something that you want me to answer for you, then you guys can do that on Instagram as well, on my DMs, because I go through those every day and I try to answer as many of you as I can, and it's really fun for me because then I can like directly talk to you guys. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I love you guys so much, and as always, I will see you guys next Saturday in next week's video. Bye. Even if the sky is falling down, even if the sky is falling down, the sky is falling. Alright, we just got to the Jeep. I just took it off the tow truck, and that was kind of unfortunate, but we walked back to it, and there's people walking towards us, and they said that they just saw it getting towed. So the tow truck guy's super nice, but we're getting it back right now. $180. Dang it.